This is David Faustino.
Hello, this is Andrew Chalmers, the writer and doctor in Doctor Who, Doctor.
This is Dr. Steve-o.
Everybody, this is the Cavernator.
This is Inspector Gadget.
Hey, what's cracking, y'all? It's your boy, J-Rock.
Good evening, folks. This is James DeVal.
This is Jeremy Taggart.
This is Kim Possible.
I'm Chris Holden-Lee.
Hey, this is Pat Mastriani from Degrassi.
This is the evil Dr. Badbox. Again, this is Missy Bear. And this is Morph from X-Men.
Hey, this is Andrew Gassess.
This is Sean Gunn.
Hi, this is Robert Carradine.
It's Tammy Stronach from The Neverending Story.
Hey, it's Zach Callison.
Hey, I'm DJ Jenny Rod.
And I'm Neil Young.
I'm Commander Shepard.
Ralph Garman here. You're listening to Droids Canada. You've made an excellent choice. You have chosen wisely.
Warning. Listener discretion is advised.
Hello.
It has been a very long time since we've been in the studio. I've been busy. You've been busy. How's your back?
How's my back? It's pretty good.
Really? Have you been exercising your back?
I have not been exercising my back.
You might need to.
Why is that?
Because I call you to fulfill your oath.
I fulfilled my duties.
Mm-mm.
What?
What did you say you were going to do if we won our fifth award?
Oh, motherfucker.
I didn't forget. They didn't forget.
Yeah.
You said you would. I didn't put this on you.
I did not put this on you.
Let the record show.
I forgot about it, but I did say if we won the award again, I would do a spin-a-rooney.
Let the record show. Dan volunteered his body.
As soon as I get clearance from the doctor.
Which is never, because you're going to stall that out as
no,
much as
no. Well. I got my next appointment coming soon, because you know what happened.
I'll go with you.
What's that?
We'll go together.
You're not coming to my doctor.
I'll hold your hand. Okay. We're friends now. We're best friends.
We
like
are.
My best man.
It's official. It's official. I even said nice things at your wedding.
I thought I was going to get roasted.
Nope.
I won't lie. And it wasn't just you either. There was a bunch of people there like, oh, fuck, I'm going to get so roasted.
No, I would not do that to someone on their wedding day.
I would.
That's what every other day's for.
Wow. Oh.
Welcome back to the Droids Canada podcast, broadcast, phenomenon.
Something.
We now have two married men in the room. Just want to give a congratulations to Mr. and Mrs. Poole. It was a lovely event.
It was.
A lovely event.
There was a botch.
What was the... There was a botch.
There was a botch.
There was a botch.
Did you... Like, was he terrified of me? Like, he thought he was going to cry?
No, he felt really bad for the botch.
Well...
He felt bad for the botch.
I wonder if he heard me when I walked in.
Everyone did.
What did I say again? You had one fucking job?
No, there was like... Oh, the music goes, well, it's too late now, buddy. Something like that. It was something like that.
Well, I mean, I'm trying to be lighthearted about things. I mean, what can I do? It was like, rewind, but boom.
Is that...
Outside because...
So just to paint the picture here, during the... Who was it? Oh, the... What song was it that was...
I don't know. Burning Glove by Elvis Presley.
Okay, and that was to introduce you as husband and wife.
Right.
Yes, and a problem that happens quite often before we start recording here,
yeah.
Something is just not plugged in right.
No.
Was not plugged in right.
Usually how she goes.
So their introductory song did not happen. The room was about 8 feet long, so by the time they took their fuse to a couple steps... It was
eight feet long.
But by the time, there was no time to fix it or to even call an audible because it was 10 seconds. Boom. No.
That's pretty much it. Yeah.
You know, the poor kid felt bad. And then you're like, well, it's too late now, buddy.
It pisses me off about that fucking day because I'm like, you know, I said to Amanda, I'm like, we'll get married in November. She's like, yeah. I'm like, yeah. She's like, why? I'm like, well, it's going to be nice weather. It's going to be one or two things. It's going to be really nice weather, and it's going to be cold. I like cold. No. Really nice weather and fucking hot.
Okay. Can you minimize that screen there? And just find out what is the record weather temperature for the date of your wedding in Niagara? Do they have that on the Googles? record weather temperature. All right, here we go. It's coming up. All right, here we go.
Ottawa broke the 84-year temperature on Saturday. Oh. Well, it was broken on our wedding day.
It was broken on your wedding day.
It was an 84-year record.
That was broken.
Oh my God. On your wedding day. And it's like everyone knows I hate heat. I hate it. Even when I was thin, I'm like,
that was Mother Nature was like, what's this?
Is that a fat person's wedding?
Bulls get married? Fuck you.
That's pretty much what happened. Hey, buddy, go fuck yourself. Enjoy the
Mother Nature wanted to show you the hot show. I still remember, once you decide on the wedding date, like, we wanted that because we want the night to be nice and cool. It wasn't. It was hot as fuck.
It was hot as fuck.
But it was a lovely event. And there you go. Sit. Hopefully she reads it right with her melatonin taking effect.
I said, fuck you, Mother Nature.
That's exactly what happened. So, what was...
Sure.
So, should this just be your you got married show?
Well, I mean, we can talk about time in Viva Las Vegas. But I have to set the mood for that.
Okay, set the mood.
I was thinking to myself the other day, there's an episode of us talking about me going to Vegas.
Yeah.
2 years ago.
It never happened.
2 years ago.
But now it did.
It's funny because yesterday I posted something that I posted last year of us announcing our wedding date. Because we had a discrepancy with someone in the wedding who said, well, I thought it was on the 4th. I'm like, I literally never said it was the 4th. It's always been the 5th. Well, I'm pretty sure you said it was on the 4th. And sure enough, yesterday I saw the post where I made a V for Vendetta reference, which is November 5th. I said in that specific post.
Remember,
twice,
remember, the 4th of November. November. What?
remember the 4th of November.
almost there.
That was the other movie. That was You for You Got It. Oh, God. My dad gave it strong.
Is that good enough? Can we move louder?
This is great.
It's funny. With Las Vegas. No Elvis.
You didn't see anything Elvis?
No.
Okay. What the hell did they do to Vegas? The Vegas that I remember.
I heard. This is a rumor. The rumor innuendo is that Graceland shot that shit down.
Graceland shot down because of the Vegas Elvis.
Did you see the movie?
No, I didn't.
It's fantastic.
Good movie?
Yeah, it's very good. What the fuck?
That's a mobile infantry. I got my Starship Troopers shirt on.
Oh my God. Look at you. Mr. Crypto King was.
Wow.
So anyways, there's no Elvis stuff. And like there is. Like you have your generic gift shop shot glass or flask. I got my mom a rubber ducky.
Like an Elvis ducky?
Oh yeah. That was the funniest thing in the world.
So that's just a duck with like black hair and sideburns.
Yeah, it's just
and glasses.
Yeah, and it's like the white jumpsuit on.
See, myself, if I could get my hands on a pair of those, like those really big Elvis glasses, I would wear those. I would
rock
those.
I just realized
those.
It's literally looping the same. It's just... I didn't see the Las Vegas sign
that's,
either.
This right here, this is. That is your trip to the Grand Canyon. It's just one loop, and it never happens.
Why would you bring that up?
Well, because we're talking about your Vegas trip.
Dirty.
It is filthy.
That is filthy. What happened?
Filthy.
So
now you're trying to find the background music to talk about Vegas, because I'm like, okay, you almost dropped your keyboard there, buddy. Hammer fist. So my Vegas was. Elvis stuff everywhere. You could buy a little like porcelain head of Elvis if you want. Like there's a lot of Elvis stuff and a lot of people along the side of the road in fluorescent shirts, snapping cards with nudie girls on them, passing them out to everyone.
Didn't see a single one.
Didn't see a single one.
Nope.
They're cleaning that place up?
They're cleaning it up. It's not as filthy. Not many homeless people either.
No?
No. Now, mind you, I want to say this. We didn't leave the strip. At all.
Neither did I.
Like, we didn't go down to, like, the stratosphere. Steeple messaged us and said, go down to the stratosphere and have a drink. It's like, you know how fucking far away that is from the tram?
It's a 10-minute. It's a 10-minute.
It's a good little walk.
I've done the walk.
Yeah, dude, so here's the fun part about Las Vegas. We didn't know there was a monorail.
Oh, yeah. Because you were staying on the opposite side of the road.
Yep. And we didn't find out until our last day.
Yep.
After we actually walked. That's usually how it goes. Well, we took the tram from the MGM Park down to the Bellagio, and then we were too early for the Bellagio fountain. So then we crossed the street, went to the Planet Hollywood, and then went to Paris, and then went to Bally's.
This is what they do in Vegas. Because there's so many magicians there, they make things appear and disappear. They make things reappear on your last day. So you go, oh, shit. So you want to come back again to see it. That's what they do. That's how they get
you. I was going to get Clooney on the horn.
Get Clooney on the horn.
I need a new Ocean's movie.
Get the best Batman on the horn.
No, I want another Ocean's movie.
Do you?
I do like the Ocean's movie.
But movies. Do you?
I like the Ocean's
movie. See?
I didn't even mind Ocean's 8. The female one.
See, I haven't seen it yet.
It's okay.
Yeah, but you hate women's wrestling and women, and women gangsters.
I do not hate women's wrestling. It's just unfortunately the matches that get stuck watching are horrible. Thank you. Prick.
Hey, no problem.
Prick.
No problem. So, sum up Vegas in three best things about Las Vegas that the newlywed Todd saw. Five best things.
Cirque du Soleil.
Cirque du Soleil.
The ca?
Ca.
It's like this,
it's like
Asian.
Eagles coming in on.
No, it's like this Asian themed Cirque du Soleil took place during, like, the Chinese Empire against the Mongolians, I'm guessing?
Maybe.
Whatever. It was crazy. You didn't understand a fucking word they said.
I want to see people doing flips.
Man, I tell you, it's fucking crazy.
Lots of flips, no fists?
Lots of flips, no fists. They are not FTR.
No.
They're not the Revival.
Well.
FTR. Whatever. I will say it's incredibly clean there. Incredible.
They do a job, well, at least from back in the days when I went there, because I'm an old fuck. They cleaned up the streets nicely every night, because at the end of the street it was just plastered in business cards with naked women on them. But that doesn't happen.
I don't get how that's legal.
What's that?
I don't get how it's legal.
I don't either. But just, it's like, everyone who goes to Vegas, that's the first thing they say, like, oh my god, these guys hand out cards with naked women on it.
What do you think the ratio of penetration is?
Penetration? Puns.
No, I mean, like, if there are so many cards, let's say they handle 500 cards a night, how many times do you think the card gets used?
Jesus.
If they're burning through that many cards a night.
That's a good question.
Not many. So, like, they're literally wasting money. Vistaprint, doing well.
Like, I don't.
But that's a question you should ask yourself.
Much. I don't know much about that industry.
Surprised you don't.
I don't.
You're Italian.
What's that?
You're Italian.
Hey.
I'm sure you got an Uncle Tony. Hey. You know, my biggest regret for my wedding was not buying you the pepper.
The pepper?
The pepper.
I
hemmed and hawed over
ward
the pepper.
Gotta ward it off.
No, I just remember when we were figuring...
Maybe that's what happened when you left.
Well, we smashed a mirror too, so...
Yeah, there was the mirror smash.
But no one touched it, so technically there's no curse. The last person who touched it was Matt.
No.
Oh, well.
You freaked me the fuck out.
What?
Because two people moved it.
Okay, who moved it?
Me.
And Matt?
Yeah.
Well, technically you have the curse.
Yeah. And what happened the next day?
Oh, yeah, a heart attack.
Yes!
Oh, yeah, shit, I forgot about that. Well, was it a heart attack, though? Did they tell you it was a heart attack, or did they say they think it's a heart attack?
They said they think.
So,
Mini... heart attack.
Yeah, but it would show up in your...
So, yes. Levels. I had a mini heart attack.
And if anyone's wondering, did Dan tell me right away? No.
Would you? Okay, so you're the best man at a wedding. You drop them off at the airport for their honeymoon.
I'd like to know.
You come home and you have a mini heart attack. Would you tell?
Made you have low blood sugar.
Would you tell the people who are on their honeymoon, like, type, get out your phone.
Of course.
Guys, hope you're having a good time on your very first night as husband and wife on your honeymoon. By the way, I had a heart attack.
Yes. I would have told you.
No.
I would have called you. I'm like, dude, I had a heart attack, man. Sorry, bro. May not be able to pick you up on Thursday. Had a heart attack.
No, I was waiting to see how things went. I'm like, yep, I'm good. So I was able to pick you up.
Well, everything worked out in the end. We did take you out for dinner, though.
I'm still waiting for the doctor appointment.
See, it's not a heart attack.
Not your health care.
Not a heart attack.
Maybe.
I'm telling you, it's not a heart attack.
We'll find out.
From my experience, we're having 2 alleged heart attacks. Mm-hmm. I'm saying alleged.
Alleged.
I had my first one. I saw the guy the next day for the one over. I can't remember what his thing was called. But he was like a on-staff heart doctor for the ER.
Okay.
And then the second time, they literally said, "Well, you know, we don't find anything, so we're just gonna give you this holster." That you're getting.
Yes.
But then maybe wear it for 2 weeks. Mm-hmm. Because, like, well, we can't find anything wrong with you, so. Let's put it on, see what happens. And then when they reviewed the data, they went, nope, you have a very good heart for a guy your size and age. It's like,
thank you. Okay.
So how long do you have to wear yours?
I don't know.
See, they're not worried about it. Because
I gotta wait
for
the... Am I a guy that worries?
Yes.
No, I'm not.
I think secretly, deep down inside, you cry yourself to sleep and worry.
No.
I think this, I just, and it's probably why you had a heart attack.
Tears make good lube. I don't. I don't. I'm not a stressy guy.
Why are you bringing up David?
Not a stressy guy.
God,
seriously, I'm not.
I'm just. You may not be. You may think up here you're not a stressy person. You could be a bottler.
Listen, what happens? Okay, when you're late, what happens?
When I'm late for what?
Anything.
I'm never late.
But. Let's say you are.
Never late.
But let's imagine you are.
I'm one of those people that leave early to ensure not late, even if I'm half an hour early.
Okay. You've never been late for anything. Ever. Not in your life.
Nothing. I mean, late for work, but I didn't care about it. Not the current job. My previous job, I didn't care. If you didn't care. I would say the last time I had a stressful moment was the first time we thought Amanda was pregnant 2 years ago.
Ah.
But it didn't bother me. I get stressed for other things.
I'm a less stressed.
I get stressed over dumb things. I get stressed over my heart rate, which is really stupid. I get stressed
because that makes your heart rate go up.
I'm aware.
Yes.
That's the worst part. Is that I'm aware, but yet I still do it to myself. It's a real and I've done the steps. I went and got medication, which I don't think fully works, and now I'm in the process of talking to someone soon. At one point. Near future one day?
I still have the pains.
You still have the pains, really?
Oh, I still have the stretch pain.
Oh, that's not good.
Oh, yeah.
Oh.
Yeah. Yesterday was...
That's not good.
What, yesterday was Tuesday? So it was a week and 2 days since my mini heart attack.
So you have, like, a pain that doesn't shoot up to your shoulder?
No, it's... Okay, so here's... I'll take you back to what happened, so... So I was...
This is how this episode's going, people. I'm sorry.
I was going...
This is your Friday episode, so we didn't do a Monday show.
I was going pee.
I was taking a piss.
Pee. We don't like the word piss. Piss. So, when I came out...
Is this music
out,
soothing for you?
That's great. Okay. That's great. I don't stress out.
I don't stress out.
Okay. So, I literally felt like... The inside of my chest was punching. Like, I could literally feel my heartbeat, like, heavy.
I feel it all the time.
And then, from there, within the next 2 seconds or so, I almost passed out.
Ooh.
Okay? I actually had to grab on to the railing of the stairs because I was going down.
Question.
Yes.
You were peeing. Now you're at the railing of the stairs. No, were you pissing on the stairs?
No, this was
I'm confused
after.
About your timelines.
Okay, so...
You went urinated.
I'm going to back it up.
You urinated.
After the pee...
Urination.
I washed my hands.
Okay, that's good. That means
I dried my hands.
Oh, that's good.
I
hygiene.
Came out.
Uh-huh.
When I came out, boom, that's when it happened.
Oh.
So after I was almost went down, almost passed out, I grabbed onto the railing and I'm like, what the fuck just happened?
No.
At this point, my lovely wife comes up and is like, what is going on? I'm like, just give me a second. I don't know. So I sit down. So when I sit down, I start getting shooting pains through my right leg. Okay? Inside of the right leg. Yeah. You know what's there?
What?
One of your arteries.
Well, yes. You have a few of those, yeah?
So, then after that...
Do you want a beer?
No.
Okay. It's a Bud Light right there.
I'm drinking it.
From the wrestling show.
Oh, fuck, maybe. after that, I was drenched in sweat.
Ooh.
Drenched, like... Within 10 seconds, like, wring my shirt out, I'm drenched.
I've had one of those.
So, then it's like, yeah, you know what, I gotta get some air. So I went outside, got a little air, tried to cool down. It's like, yep, going to the hospital. So, I drove myself to the hospital. Like,
see,
idiot,
this
but...
is where I want you to promise me that if this occurs again, you're gonna call me and I'm gonna come take you to
the hospital.
Oh, I
got shit by everyone. By everyone.
Oh my god, I would have just drove you to punch you in
the
dick.
I'm gonna call you in Vegas?
Well, no, but I would have had someone come get you.
I had a house full of people.
And obviously not one of them took you to the hospital.
No, because I'm just like, I'm going. Literally,
guys, only one
person in the house knew, and that's the one person who doesn't drive. So, like, I didn't want to worry him. So,
you don't want to worry them. You're like, I'm having shooting chest pains, and my leg hurts. I'm going to pass out.
I want to drive.
Like, you sound like my dad. You're talking to a guy who has a father who had a diabetic stroke and kept it to himself all day.
But I made it. I knew I had to, so then...
Imagine if you didn't make it.
Blah, 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 yada, yada, blood test, blood test, blood test,
selfish. You're being selfish. What if you didn't make it and you died while I was gone? Hear me out. I had to go back out in the job market and find a new co-host. You ungrateful son of a bitch.
Yeah.
Really, you've been on the show for 7 years. I figured it out, actually. You asked me a month ago. I figured it out. 2015.
I didn't think about the show.
2015 is when you joined the show.
Was it still snowy though? No, it was like Mayish.
It was summerish.
Summerish.
Because I got a post that it was in 2016, and that's when we were doing the red border, and I'm like, it was the previous summer, because I did that red border at the beginning of the year. You wouldn't remember that. It's graphics. You don't pay attention to that stuff. But I remember that. I was like, huh, because. One of the first episodes we did collectively when you came on was The Walking Dead when the parent teacher council scolded The Walking Dead, and the girl with the fishnets. Oh, they were funny too. Those are really funny episodes.
I don't remember.
I know they were like one of the original ones. They were hilarious. So 7 years now.
7 years. There's yeah, you know what? I'm a selfish fuck. I didn't think of the show.
I mean, I'd have to go out there and get a new person. You know how hard it is to find a co-host? I've been through eight.
Eight?
Eight. And I'm sure it's not me.
So, moving on. I don't know. What do you say we wrap this up and then we'll move to some of our other stuff on our next...
I mean, you're going to find that we're going to have a bunch of backed up ones because, holiday's coming. We gotta get ahead.
Yeah, and someone was married.
Because someone's gotta go to fucking Peterborough for 2.5 years. As usual.
Peterborough!
Alright.
Bye-bye.
And I'm saying, woo, right here. I'm the man.